Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this part, we are going to consider the fragment. This is the fragment that we are going to concentrate in this tutorial. Now, this fragment can further be subdivided into three main layers as indicated by the boxes below. This is the first one, the red box that will hold the featured products headline of this part of the template. This is the second box, that means the second div that will hold all the paragraph contents inside. And this is the third, the green box that will practically hold all the images and the captions inside. Now let's first black out the above two parts, that means this featured product and the paragraph part, and let's concentrate into this green box. It is further be subdivided into two more boxes, into two more divs, the extreme left box and the extreme right box. Those will contain the images along with their captions. So this is the first one, the extreme left box with the image and the caption, the red one, and this is the extreme right box, the blue box, in a similar way that will hold the images and the captions. This is the way we are going to create this part of the template in this tutorial. All you need to do is to carefully watch the rest of the video till end. So this is the thing that we are going to discuss in this tutorial. Please keep watching this video till end and subscribe us to stay tuned for more. Keep watching and enjoy learning. So let's hop into our tutorial. As we can see, as we have told you before, that this is the part that has been constructed so far of this template. This is the template that we are about to build, and we have built so far up to this one, up to this part. So the rest of the things should be built now, such as it looks like this one. This is the end product, and after that we will be creating the last of this template, which is this footer part, this one. So let's get back to our tutorial. So the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to create this featured products headline here. So that is why I have taken an H3. What I did here, I just customized it. The font family is cell regular. You remember the part here, the cell regular part that had been introduced into this tutorial in the very beginning. And then the font size is 2em. I have restricted the font size to 2em, the text align being left and the color being this one. And in index.html, now let's get back to our project and reload, and we can see that featured products is already been introduced into our web browser. So this is the part. Now the second thing that we are needed to do here is this paragraph element. So that is why we need to introduce another h4 header tag. So all we are doing, we are just creating this h4 element. I have practically introduced this font family, this slabo 27.px, 27 peaks. So all we need to do, slabo, this is the font that we are looking here. Here it is. We need to select this font family. Then let's come back to our tutorial and paste it over here. Now the font size is, let's get back to Google, and here we will look for dummy text generator as it been seen over here. Get back to index.html here. Now as I have placed it over here, now all we need to do, we need to press Ctrl S and get back to our project and reload. This is our project. Let's reload, and we can see that it is now here. But font, I think this font family is not working, as it is now using the default font family as described by the browser. So we need to check it out what is happening here. Here it is. I have practically used H3 again, and here it is H4. So all we need to do, we need to convert it to H4, and here it is. The header tag is H4. So let's get back to our project and reload. And there it is. The font size is a little bit bigger, so all we need to do, we need to change it. As I have told you that you need to make experiments with it. So I have provided this 0.9 em here, and let's get back to our project and reload, and we can see that this is the font family and this is the font size that we have prescribed so far. So these two parts here, as we can see, these are the two parts. These two parts here are fixed. It has no problem. Another thing, we need to provide some padding if it is needed to be done here. So that is why I am getting back to H4 tag and providing a padding. A padding of 1 em. So now we are just getting back to our project, reloading, and we can see that this is the thing. But it seems to be a little bit of more. So all we need to do, we need to make it less here. Go with it. Here it is. And now we can see that the padding is alright. Now it's time for the main part of this template. It is the images, this image folder. As we can see that, we can see here that there are two images present into the central position. The first thing, all we need to do, we need to create another div. So I am naming it as image holder. That means this thing will be now centrally positioned, centrally aligned. Getting back to index.html, and beneath this h4 tag, we are now introducing the div here. As we can see that that a div has been introduced over here, but still we cannot see it, as it cannot render its background properties. That's why it is keeping invisible in front of us. So all we need to do, we need to get back to our project and first of all provide a background color. As I have told you that the background color is the only color that distinguishes a particular div with another. So provide any background color. I am providing a black background here. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project, reload, and you can see that a div has been introduced into your featured product segment. All I did behind the scene, that I have created practically into this image folder, I have already produced two images with a particular dimension of 500px by 500px. It is a square one. So all we need to do, we need to get back to our project, and before making anything, let's break this dot form feature parent left box image holder into two particular . So all I'm going to do is to copy this thing again. Let's get back to index.html, and inside this div, I am now introducing these two divs over here. Okay, now we are good to go. So all we need to do now is to introduce the image part. Same thing should be done over here in case of right box element. Now these two things been assigned over here. So all we need to do, we need to get back to index.html, and here inside this left box, let's call the image source. All we need to do, we need to copy it, and inside this right box we are pasting it again, this time changing the file name to flower2 and alt tag attribute to flower2, as we can see here. Now first of all, press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and see what is happening out there. So this is the display that we can see. Now it's time to remove these backgrounds, but before that we need to make some certain orientations, such as delete some of these parts. Up to this part I will be deleting this thing off, no need of it. There it is. Another thing, if you are asked ever to make these images circular in nature, so all you need to do, you need to get back to your project, and here in this stylesheet.css and within these images, you need to mention this border radius. Here it is. I have mentioned border radii over here. Now let's get back to our project and reload, and we can see that these images are now, they are practically circular in nature. They are not oval. They are not square anymore. Now it's time to comment out these backgrounds over here. So we are getting back. Now let's get back to our project and press Ctrl S, and we can see that this is practically done. Another thing that we need to mention, all we did, we just entered into this form feature parent and we provided a margin, flat margin of 30 pixels, and you can see that each and every contents inside this particular element, it is now descending down a total distance of 30 pixels from the top. So that is why this is the only change. This is the only major change that I have done so far. We do not have to change anything anywhere else. All we need to do, we need to change into a particular place, and these changes will be reflected throughout into this, into your project. And that is why I have always enforced you to create, to wrap your contents inside a particular wrapper, and then you proceed forward. This will reduce your time in a post-project condition. Now the rest thing is presenting those captions. In this particular case, I'll be returning back to our project, and here I'll be including a new particular tag which is known as figcaption, as we can see here. This is practically an HTML5 element, but we may include it over here and see what is the result that is coming. If you are not satisfied with this figcaption, then we may change it anytime to H2 or H3. That means the normal header tags that are used over here. But first of all, we need to learn about it, and when we'll be learning about HTML5, we will be observing how to use this. So let's get back to our project. Here, figcaption. We have this name, which is, if we get back to our template, we can see that this is the name Red Revolution and Serpenta. So these are the things that we are going to write over here. Red, just press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload. These two things are coming right over here. We have to customize this figcaption element over here. Get back to our project, and here we can see that all these things are now changed. Practically we need to change these font colors over here. So that is why we need to get back to the template, and here we mention this color. No need to provide this line height, just provide a padding of, get back to your project, reload, and you can see that this project is already present inside your document, inside the web browser. This is the thing that we are going to do in our next tutorial, and with it we are going to end up this project as soon as possible, and then we'll be proceeding towards our next tutorial, which is concerned about bootstrap presentation, bootstrap or mobile responsiveness of your website, how to make your websites mobile responsive. So if you have liked our tutorial, please do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button. I hope you have liked our tutorial. We will hope to see you in our next tutorial. Till then, bye.